Hello, multi-Mancunian machining monsters. And thank you to ShawJohn31 for that malt mention. This, many monsters, is the Manx Bothy, and I'm Ralph, the Bunnity Scotsman, with the tartan jacket. A little bit cliched, but it still works after 10 years. And this is Ralphie Review 770 Extras, in which, having reviewed, done a double review, a more in-depth review of the readily available, accessible Highland Park 12-year-old rebranding as the Honour bottling, and this thoroughly outstanding, superb single cask bottling of Highland Park for Oddbins, which was done back in 2007. And I enjoyed it so much, as soon as I got out of the shop, because I knew even then I had to move quickly in this, because I learned that it was only one case per shop. In fact, some shops only had two or three bottles. And I walked 3 miles from one Oddbins to the next Oddbins branch to buy the last remaining bottle so I could have two. As soon as I had opened the bottle outside the back of the shop, behind the bins, discreetly where nobody could see me drinking in public, had a sniff, had a taste, and decided, bloody hell, this is seriously good single malt. I better get another bottle if I can. It's all part of the journey. Now, two things I want to discuss. One is the law of diminishing returns. And you probably noticed the discrepancy between the malt marks. The standard available brand, chill filtered, probably, possibly some caramel added. They don't say one way or the other. If they didn't add caramel, they should state it on the label where we can know about it properly, officially. The label's the contract malt mates, we know that. So do the distillers, they know that too. It's a decent single malt, and I commend Highland Park for having a reasonably priced, widely available version of their whiskey. So people, the first impression they get of Highland Park is great. This is an age statement whiskey, an age statement single malt. It's not like the other non-age statements on the shelf, which taste maybe a little bit two-dimensional. But having said that, if you're an occasional whiskey drinker, and you're not familiar with whiskey, so you're a very occasional sipper of whiskies, you're really going to enjoy that because you don't have any point of reference. But if you were to drink this after you drunk this, the cask strength single cask version, you're probably going to be quite disappointed, particularly if you have the experience in your journey and have access and you've got the budget to go out and buy this, because you know how damn good it is. It's superb single malt. Stunningly good. For a specific reason. I'll come to that shortly. Then, what you have is increasing depreciation of early values due to bigger budget, drinking more whiskey and drinking a wider variety of whiskey. In other words, it's the law of diminishing returns. The more good whiskey that we taste, the more we know what good whiskey is, the more we search out for it and buy it. And this is why we buy independent bottlings, to get the higher strength and more flavoured stuff. But the problem is, when we have indulged in these more expensive, less available, more specialised bottlings for single malt fans, we go back to the standard bottlings and we find them a little bit less and a little bit thinner because they're bottled weaker, they are chill filtered, so there's simply less mouthfeel, and they are large batch productions to get the volume of bottlings to justify the access to different markets around the world so that they're widely available. You know, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of bottlings of these, but only one. What? How many bottles are these? Not that many. Less than 1,000. So there's very, very few whiskey customers that are going to go for this. But those who do will really understand and enjoy this, particularly if you have this first. Then you go on to this, you really see the difference, huge difference. It's the law of diminishing returns. The more we smell whiskey, the more we taste whiskey, the more we get to instinctively discover what's good about whiskey, then the more we see through the less good bottlings. And it's not that they're bad. It's not the case. It's just that they, by their very nature, offer less in terms of smell and taste. There are exceptions, of course. But it's our journey, it's our job, it's our hobby to play that Sherlock Holmes game of discovering what's the best of what's available to us at the right price. It's part of the challenge. Do you know, it's part of the adventure. It's part of the reason we enjoy it. It's not just about the whiskey. It's about the whiskey chase, the whiskey company, the whiskey rapport, the whiskey friends, the quality of the companionship in the whiskey scene. But let me now talk about this bottling. Why is it so good? It's down to the cask. Sure, the Highland Park Spirit, it's very similar between the two bottles. In my opinion, it's a little bit better in this because the phenolic notes are a little bit fresher and crisper and clearer. There's just more delivered through from out the stills for whatever reason. But it's the cask that carries this. It's the cask which has worked beautifully in only 12 years. It's produced an outstanding, stunningly good single malt whiskey, which once tasted will never be forgotten. So what is it about that cask? I'll tell you what it is. It's a 1 in 100 cask. Let me explain. Every warehouseman has an important job. Their most important job, apart from stopping leaks in casks and managing the ins and outs of casks to the bottling plant and in from the distillery, is actually knowing the quality of the casks themselves. Casks are stored as parcels. Parcels of cask may be from 10, 20, 100, 1,000 casks. They represent a period of distillation, a certain style of cask, whether it be sherry or bourbon or wine or port. And the warehouseman or warehousewoman, whatever, whoever's got the best nose, that's what matters to us, will know which casks are the best casks and which casks are the not so good casks. The casks that make up the filler in the blends of single malts, and the other casks which are maybe not quite good enough for single malts, but they'll be fine, sold off to the independent bottling market, to the wholesalers out there, or to the blenders to go into their blended Scotch whiskies. And within their parcels, the warehouse personnel, as they go around smelling and tasting, and I'm telling you, the novelty of that soon wears off. But it's a job. They've got to have experienced noses, literally, to go in and out a cask in the space of a minute and a half to 2 minutes. They can't hang around here. There's too many casks to get through. Frankly, it's not a glamorous job. It may seem so. We'd love to do it, but just for a day. No more than a day. And every now and again, they will take the bung off a cask and they'll nose inside that cask. And they'll say, bloody hell, that's seriously good stuff. It's not just a good cask. It's not just a good spirit. It's good cask, good spirit coming together even better. This is a 1 in 100 cask. A 1 in 100 cask. This cask, to the nose of the warehouse person, is better than the 99 casks that surround it. And as such, they have to make a careful note, and they may occasionally put a chalk mark or even a staple into the end of the cask if they're doing it in code. So only they know and nobody else knows. Aye. Insider secrets. And that is the 1 in 100 cask. And every now and again, you'll get 1 in 1,000 cask. They're very few and far between. They're the ones that are groomed from the very start. The very best distillate going into the most expensive and the best provenanced casks, wherever they come from. And these are the ones that are being specially selected and put to the quietest part of the warehouse, where they will not be interfered with or likely to be damaged by passing forklift trucks. And they will be groomed to go the age, the distance, the years, the decades to produce the exceptional whiskey that justifies the enormous price tag simply because it's 50, 60, 70, 75, 80, 90, or even 100 years old. Now you know. That's what your 1 in 100 cask is. I'm Ralphy. I hope you've enjoyed this little bit of added extras. I'm here to be helpful, here to share my journey, to help you with your journey. And I hope you will join me soon for more Ralphy Reviews here in the Manx Bothy. See you soon, maltmates.